Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at how to deploy a Laravel project on a server using Cloudways. I have already created one video before, almost about a month ago, as you can see here. But in this video, I have shown you everything by doing it manually. I installed Nginx, MySQL, PHP, everything myself by creating a DigitalOcean droplet, and then I showed you how to deploy a Laravel project there. But whenever we use Cloudways, we don't have to worry about it. We don't have to worry about the setting of the server. It will do everything for us. I'll be leaving a link just below that like button. And whenever you visit that link, it will take you to this website. And there is a Black Friday deal going on. And if you sign up within that period, then you'll get 40% off. And after watching this video, you will realize that how easy it is to upload a Laravel project using Cloudways. You can compare this video and the previous video that I have made. I'll be leaving a link to that video also just below that like button. And guys, I have to mention that this video is sponsored by Cloudways. Thank you for the Cloudways team for reaching out and sponsoring this video. So without any further ado, let's get started. So just go to that link and click on this get 40% off. Then it will take you to this registration page. Just fill your information and add this BFCM2021 promo code here and you will get 40% off for 4 months. And there is also one promo code that they have provided to me. And if you use that promo code, then you will get 20% discount, even if you register after the Black Friday. So after you have registered, it will take you to this dashboard. I have already created a server before to test it, but now I'll create a new server and I'll show you. So I'll add a new server from here and I'll click on here, the Laravel. So here is the Laravel version 8.26.1. So it doesn't mean that you'll be tied to the specific 8.26.1 version of Laravel. You can easily upgrade using Composer. So I'll just click on here and let me say Laravel 2 and the same for here, and let me just keep the project name as Laravel. And whenever you are creating for the first time, here it will also have a text field where you can add the name of the project. I already have a project, so I'll just use that. Now here you can use a bunch of options: DigitalOcean, Linode, Vultr, AWS, or Google Cloud Platform. Since I used DigitalOcean in my previous video, so I'll be using DigitalOcean here also. And if you have seen my previous video, there I had to create a DigitalOcean droplet myself, but here Cloudways will do that for me. So let us just select this 4GB RAM and 80GB space. And you have to keep one thing in mind that you cannot downgrade. You can only upgrade your server. Okay. After you have set up your server to 4GB, you cannot just take it down to the 2GB. So keep that in mind. So let us just make 4GB here. And regarding the location, let me choose Bangalore over here since it is nearest to my country. Now let's click on launch now. You can see here it is creating a server, and you can see here it will take about 7 minutes to set up the server, and I'll come back after 7 minutes. Okay guys, the Laravel 2 server has been successfully created. Now let's go inside it. Just click here. Here you will see the credentials of your server: the IP address, username, and password. So let's just log in using this IP address and username. So I'll just click here to copy, and let me move to terminal, and here I'll say SSH, and here I'll just write the username. And I'll just copy this IP address by clicking on it, and then I'll just paste it over here. And guys, in your case, you have to just write this. You don't have to write this -o before and all these things, okay? Because I have something set up in my laptop, so I have to write this, but you don't have to write this. Just write up to here and then hit enter. And it will just ask for you, are you sure you want to continue? Then I'll say just yes and hit enter. Then it will ask for the password. Just click here to copy the password and I'll paste it over here and hit enter. Now I have successfully logged into the server. If I just show you ls like this, you can see here applications, and let me cd into applications. And then if I just show you other, so here is just a random directory which Cloudways creates. So I'll say cd this, and here inside ls you can see the public underscore html folder. So I'll just cd into public_html, and here if I do ls, then you can see the Laravel project structure. In order to see it in a list, you can just say ls -la. So the A option will show the hidden files as well, and -l will show it in a list. So you can see here all the files that are required for the Laravel. Now, if I come here and just go here in the www and just click here in the Laravel 2, then it will show me this access details, and it will show me the application URL by which we can visit and see what's inside the server. So I'll just click here, and you can see here this is the default page that Cloudways provides to us. But we don't want this, we want our application to be uploaded over here, and we'll do that by using GitHub. So here I have already one project, and whatever I do in my channel, I always post to this repository. So I'll just take this. It can be either public or private, okay? So now here you can see deployment via Git. So let me just zoom it for you guys. So here it is, deployment via Git. Let me just click here. Now we have to create a Ssh key. Just click here. Now it has successfully created a Ssh key for us. Let us just click here and view the Ssh key. So I'll just click here to copy, and we have to paste it inside the GitHub. So here I have this repository. I'll go here inside the settings, and I'll go here in the deployment keys, and I'll add deploy key from here, and I'll just paste that over here, and let's say Laravel Cloudways 2. And we don't need to provide the write access to it, because Cloudways will never write to the repository. It will only read from this repository. So add key, I'll confirm the password, and it has created the Laravel Cloudways 2 key here. Now here we need to add the Git remote address. So I'll go here, and here inside the project, I'll just click here inside the code and copy this URL and paste it over here. Now we have to just click this authenticate, and it has successfully authenticated and just pulled the branches that we have in our project. So if I just click here, I'll see a bunch of branches over there, but the branch that you want to deploy to the production server, just select that. In our case, it's a master branch, and we want to deploy it in the public_html directory. So it's fine. Now I'll click on start deployment. So you can see here it is saying deployment in progress, and it will take some time to deploy this project to this Cloudways/DigitalOcean server in our case. So it has successfully cloned the repository. Now if I go to this link and click on refresh, now you can see some Laravel related error. So it is saying access denied for user root at localhost, which means that we need to set up the database. So that's also very easy in Cloudways. So just go here, and you can see here access details, and here you can see the database name, username and password. I'll just copy this and paste it in our .env file. So just copy, and here if I just show you ls -la, then here is .env file. So I'll say vi.env. I'll open it using vim. So here in the db database, we'll write this, and in the username also we have this, and the password here it is this. And I'll just remove this server after adding this video to the YouTube, so don't try to just copy and paste all these credentials that I have used. And here instead of localhost, we'll just write this URL. And one thing guys, for security, you need to always turn this to false, this app debug, whenever you are deploying a project to a production server. But in this case, we are just testing it, so app debug will give us some necessary information whenever something goes wrong. So I'll just write and save, and now if I reload, then the error message should change. There will still be some errors, but error message will change. So you can see here it is saying base table or view not found categories, which means that we don't have categories table, so we need to run migrate. So before that, let me show you the Laravel version here, php artisan version, so it is 8.26.1, and this is the exact same version that we have seen whenever we are installing the Laravel from the Cloudways. We can upgrade this by just running composer install, and whenever we do composer install, it will just match the local Laravel version that we have installed to this version. And guys, it is throwing an error because by default there is PHP version 7.4, and we can easily change the PHP version as well. I'll show you that also. So to change the PHP version, we have to go here and just click here. It will take us to the server list, and just go to the settings and packages, and just go here inside the packages, and here you will see the PHP, MySQL, Elasticsearch, Redis, Supervisor. Now to change the PHP version, just click on edit, and the highest version that it supports is PHP version 8, which is the latest PHP version, and PHP 8.1 is about to be released, and hopefully after it is released, after some time, it will be added over here as well. So if I just click here and click on save, and it is just showing me warning that all the things that we have written or the code that we have is compatible with the PHP version 8. So we'll say okay. Now it will take a while to change the PHP version. So I'll just come back after it is done. The PHP version has been successfully changed to 8.0. So I can confirm you by doing PHP version like this. So it is 8.0.13. So since we are inside the Laravel project, let's do composer install now. So you can see here it is now proceeding successfully. Now if I say here PHP artisan --- version, then it is the latest version of Laravel, which is 8.73.2. Now let me migrate PHP artisan migrate like this. Okay, now if I go here and just reload, then you can see here your page, but the CSS and JavaScript are missing. So now let us fix this as well. So I'll say npm install and npm run production. So this is also a successful. Now if I just come here and refresh, you can see here that we have successfully deployed our Laravel project to the Cloudways server. And if I just click here, there are no categories, but I have a factory. So I'll just say PHP artisan tinker, and here I'll say category factory 3. Let's say we'll create 3 categories, and here I'll say create like this. So I have created 3 categories. Now if I come here, reload, then we can see those 3 categories over here. And you can see here guys, it is so easy to deploy a Laravel project using the Cloudways. We can compare this with my previous video of deployment, then you can see that we don't have to worry about server management. And if you see here in the Cloudways dashboard, there are so many options. So we have options for monitoring as well. And here you can see how much RAM is being used, CPU, disk usage, everything. And again, if you go here inside www and here Laravel 2, then also here we have monitoring. And also guys, you can also manage database just like PHP admin. Just click here and it will show the PHP MyAdmin like dashboard, not same like PHP MyAdmin, but similar, and you can just update your data from there and just view it visually. And if I just click here in the analytics, then we can see here traffic, PHP, MySQL, and running cron jobs, disk usage. Also we can see the access log and error log. And if you see here in the domain management, you can add a custom domain over here. Just add your primary domain here and click on save changes. And for more information, you can just click here. Since I don't have a custom domain, so I'll not be able to show you that, but you can just click here and it will take you to the complete guide on how to do that, and it is very very easy. Similarly for SSL certificate also, here we can use Let's Encrypt, or if you have a custom certificate, then also you can just use that certificate. And if you click here and click on more details on each of the topic to see how to do that, if you just click here, then here also they have blog as well as a video tutorial on how to do this. It will be very easy for you to do this. Similarly, we can backup and restore as well. You can just click here to directly take a backup now, or you can just schedule a backup. So you can schedule a backup by going to the previous option. Just click here and go back to the previous option. So I'll show you that also. So just click here and click on backups, and then you can set up the schedule time and just click here on the enable and save changes. Then it will automatically backup, and from the options that we have seen before, we can restore the backups as well. And let's say in the future, if you want to change 4GB to 6GB or 8GB or increase the storage, then you can just go here in the vertical scaling, and then you can just slide this over here like this. Let's say we want 16GB, and just click on scale now, then it will upgrade your server. And if you want to change something like PHP maximum timeout setting or maximum upload size, then you can go here inside settings and packages, and it is divided into multiple tabs. So here in the basic, you can just change execution limit, upload size, memory limit, display error or not. And if you want to change the time zone, then you can also change it from here. And in the advanced option, you have this maximum input variables, max input time, upcast memory, and so many other options. You can just have a look at it, and you can just change the MySQL time zone as well from here. So you can see here everything, every options is over here. And these packages we have already seen before. So here we can change PHP, MySQL, we can install Redis and Supervisor as well. And these are the topics for the separate video. And if you click here in the optimization, you can see here so many options over here, like remove all the files from the temp folder, or remove the files from the private underscore HTML, or local backups, or logs, or var logs folder. You can just do this. Or automatic disk cleanups, and it will automatically run the cleanups by using these settings. And now if you go here in the manage services, then we can restart MySQL, Apache, Nginx. So by default it will use Nginx, so we can just restart the Nginx. If we change something on the Nginx, or we can just restart FPM, we don't need to remember any command, which can just do everything from the UI. We have already seen this monitoring, so let's go here in the master credentials. So here you can just use the Ssh key to log in as well. If you just click here, you can just add the public key over here and just keep your private key on your local machine, and you can just log in by using SSH. Instead of writing IP address, you can just create a config file in your local computer and just use the name like SSH space Cloudways, and it will directly log you in. And you can also launch the terminal from here. If you just click here, it will open a new terminal for you, and you can just run any commands that you want. So as you can see, we can do a lot of things from the UI. We don't have to remember any code or any terminal commands. We can just do easily from this dashboard. So I hope you enjoyed this video, guys, and I'll be leaving a link just below that like button where you can click and visit the Cloudways website, where you will get 40% Black Friday deal. And if that Black Friday deal is over, then also I'll add different promo code which you can use even after the Black Friday deal to get 20% discount. So that's it for this video, guys. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye.